Hey everyone, welcome back to Neural Enterprises. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about backpropagation algorithm. Backpropagation algorithm is used to learn the weights of a multi-layer neural network with fixed architecture. What it basically does is, it performs a gradient descent to try to minimize the sum squared error between the network's output values and the given target values. Okay, so loosely speaking, we can say that backpropagation algorithm helps us to calculate the gradient of cost function. Let's see how this works with the help of a simple neural network. So, consider that this is a neural network used to classify the input pattern into two classes, that is class A and class B. Okay, so let's say that this is the neuron dedicated for class A and this is the neuron dedicated for class B. That is, when a class A input comes, it is this neuron that gets activated. Okay, now consider that initially the network is not properly trained. So when we provide a class A input, the activation of the neuron corresponding to class A is only 0.4. So what we have to do is, we need to increase the activation over here. Also note that I represent positive correlation between neurons with the help of white synaptic connections and negative correlation with the help of red synaptic connections. What I meant by positive correlation is that when the activation of this particular neuron increases, since these two are positively correlated, the activation of this neuron also increases. And similarly, since these two neurons are negatively correlated, when the activation of this neuron increases, it will in turn decrease the activation of this output neuron. Okay. So, in order to increase the activation value of this output neuron to the desired value of 1, we should increase the activation of this neuron, increase the activation of this neuron, but decrease the activation of this neuron. Let's mark it over here. Okay. But this is not the entire picture. We also have another output neuron corresponding to class B, right? And let's say that the activation of B is 0.5 when we give an input corresponding to class A. So we need to bring down the activation of this output neuron to desired value of 0. Also, let's consider that these two neurons are negatively correlated. This is positively correlated and these two are negatively correlated again. So, in order to bring down the activation of this, we need to increase the activation of this neuron, decrease the activation of this neuron and increase the activation of this neuron. Let's mark it also there. Okay, so we have marked that also. Now, the effective change in activation brought to these neurons, that is neurons in this hidden layer, can be found by some of the activations which is to be done to these neurons. So, if we take the case of this particular neuron, we can see that we need to increase the activation of this neuron so as to increase the activation over here and decrease the activation over here. But we can directly change the activation of this neuron. In order to change the activation of this neuron, we should change the synaptic weights connected to this neuron. So, we can see that in order to change the activation of this neuron, we need to tweak the values of these two synaptic weights, which is again dependent upon the activation of these two neurons. So, in effect, we can see that we are propagating backwards. It is in this context, the term backpropagation comes into relevance. Okay, so I hope that you understood this part very clearly. Now, let's start the mathematics behind backpropagation algorithm by taking an extremely simple network, that is, one where each layer has only a single neuron in it. Okay, so here there is only one neuron, in this layer also one neuron, and in this layer also one neuron. Okay, so we can say that the output of this particular net is determined by the weight over here and weight over here. And our goal is to understand how sensitive this output is to these variables. Okay, that way we will get to know which adjustment to these terms decrease the cost function most efficiently. Now let's label the layers. So I am labeling this layer as L, this layer as L minus 1 and this layer as L minus 2. Okay. Now bear with me very carefully. I am denoting the activation of this last neuron as YL and that of previous neuron as YL minus 1. Okay. And let this synaptic weight be denoted as WL. Not that these are not exponents, but just the index given to the notations. Okay. Now, let the desired value for the output neuron be D. So, the cost function for this simple network for a single training sample is E equal to D minus YL the whole square. Okay. Similarly, we can write YL as some activation function of YL minus 1 into WL. For simplification purposes, I am writing YL minus 1 into WL as VL. Okay. Therefore, this equation becomes phi of VL. So, in brief, we can say that the weight WL and the activation of the previous neuron, that is this neuron, is used to calculate VL, which is used to calculate YL, which along with D is used to calculate the cost function. So you can see that a tiny change in WL can cause a change in VL, which causes a change in YL, which in turn causes a change in the cost function. Also, you can see that this YL minus 1 is affected by the weight and the activations of the previous units. Okay. Now, our first goal is to understand how sensitive is the cost function to changes in WL. That is, we need to calculate dou E by dou WL. Okay. But in order to find this value, we first need to understand how VL is affected by WL. So we will write dou VL by dou WL. Now, since we know how VL is affected, we can calculate how YL is affected. Therefore, dou YL by dou VL. And finally, we can calculate the changes of E with respect to YL. Therefore, dou E by dou YL. Now, we can calculate dou VL by dou WL using this equation. Therefore, dou VL by dou WL can be written as YL minus 1. Similarly, dou YL by dou VL can be obtained from this equation, which is dou YL by dou VL equal to phi dash of VL. Now, finally, dou E by dou YL can be written as dou E by dou YL equal to 2 times D minus YL minus 1. Therefore, the final expression can be written as dou E by dou WL equal to YL minus 1 into phi dash VL into let me write the minus over here, 2 D minus YL. Okay, keep in mind that this thing we calculated over here is just the cost function for a single training sample. The full cost function over all training samples can be found as the average of cost functions for individual training samples. So we can write dou C by dou omega L equal to 1 by N sigma k equal to 1 to n dou ck by dou omega l. But again, note that this is just a component of the Dadian vector which consists of partial derivatives of cost functions with respect to all the weights in the network. For example, if we consider the case of our simple neural network considered over here, we can write gradient c as dou c by dou wl and dou C by dou WL minus 1. Why only two components? Because there are only two synaptic weights in this neural network. Okay. Keep in mind that in actual practice, the gradient vector will be really large because actual neural network consists of many hidden layers and also many synaptic connections between each of these neurons. Now, one might ask, what would happen to this equation as we increase the complexity of the neural network? So let's probe into that. Here is a neural network which is slightly more complex than one we considered before, okay? Here, let me write this layer as layer L and this layer as layer L minus 1, okay? Also, I will use the subscript K for output neurons and J for the input neurons. And in similar fashion, the weight between layers L and L minus 1 is denoted as WKJL, okay? Now, if you look into how the equations get modified, you can find that VKL can be given as sigma WKJL into YJL minus 1, where J ranges from 1 to NL. that is number of neurons in layer L. Similarly, YKL is given as phi of EKL, and also the cost function gets modified as sigma dk minus yk the whole square, where k ranges from 1 to n L minus 1, that is number of neurons in the layer L minus 1. Okay, now if you do the math, you can see that the equation doesn't change at all, except for the fact that we added some subscripts to it. Okay, that's all for this lecture. I hope that everyone understood the lecture clearly. And if you have any doubts, please do ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.